Hi, my name is Mitchell, and I'm a manufacturing engineer here at Haas Automation. Daily and weekly maintenance tasks are crucial to make sure that your Haas mill is running in tip-top shape. However, the reality is that some shop owners take better care of their cars, which will only ever cost them money, than their mills, which actually make them money. Taking a few minutes out of your day to take care of your machine may cost you a few bucks in the here and now. However, you will be money ahead in the long run, especially when considering the alternative, paying thousands of dollars to replace worn down components on your mill, in addition to the loss of revenue due to machine downtime. Plus, maintaining your machine might actually be easier than you think. For example, every morning when I get to work, I make myself a cup of coffee. In the time it takes me to brew that one cup, I can actually get several maintenance tasks done. The first thing you should do is run the Spindle Warm Up program located on the program page. You should definitely do this if your machine has been idle for more than a couple of days, but it is still recommended for everyday use, especially if running the spindle at high RPMs. While the Spindle Warm Up program is running, check the airlines for water by depressing the trigger on the air gun and make sure to keep it pointed away from you. Since the air gun is fed from the bottom of the manifold, any water in the system will escape when the trigger on the air gun is activated. However, if you consistently have water in the line, this is a sign of a bigger issue going on with the compressed air system in your shop. Next, open the Diagnostics page on the control and check for air pressure and coolant level. Check to make sure that they are both at an acceptable level for operating your machine. Finally, check the coolant concentration, especially when working in a high production or hot environment where the concentration is affected by carryout or evaporation. Using a refractometer, verify that the concentration in your tank matches the manufacturer's specifications, usually between 6 and 8%. Now the morning maintenance on my machine is done, and I can enjoy a nice cup of coffee as well. Throughout the day, make sure to check the tool holders, pull studs, and tool tapers for damage. This can easily be done each time you need to swap or replace tools. Make sure that none of the tool tapers have rust, galling, or chips present on the taper, as this can damage the spindle in addition to causing bad finishes and part tolerances. After each shift, or at the end of every day, clear off any chips present on the way covers and evacuate them from the machine using a chip auger or conveyor. Use a brush to remove the larger chips and follow up with the air gun to remove the rest. This prevents chips from putting unnecessary strain on the way cover seals, as well as ensures that the ferrous chips, such as steel or cast iron, do not begin to rust within the machine. Check the chip filter on top of the coolant tank and remove any excessive piles of chips that may be present and restricting the flow of coolant back into the tank. And finally, if there is a tool in the spindle, make sure to remove it before leaving the machine to sit overnight. Use a rust inhibitor like WD-40 to clean and lubricate the spindle taper. Spray on a small amount of the rust inhibitor and then wipe down the taper with a clean, dry rag. These are all the tasks that we recommend doing every day. However, there are some additional tasks that should be done once a week, for example, every Friday. The first of these is to clear off chip buildup on the side-mounted tool changer arm and check for sticky plungers or worn keys. If you have an umbrella-style tool changer, make sure to clear off the chips from the top of the protective cover and check the extractor forks and keys for excessive wear and damage. Next, inspect the air regulator pressure gauge, located in the loop panel on your machine, and verify that it matches the reading on the control and is within the acceptable operating range. With the diagnostic page open, check the coolant flow gauge and verify that it is operating properly and the displayed reading matches the actual level in your tank. Check the surface of the coolant tank for tramp oil and remove any present using an absorbent pad. You can even use shop towels for this in a pinch. If you consistently see tramp oil in your tank, you might consider investing in an oil skimmer to keep your coolant performing at its best. Next, remove the coolant filter from its housing and remove any chips caught in the mesh. If you have TSSE on your mill, check the TSSE filter on the bottom side of the TSSE pump for excessive buildup that might affect the coolant flow. Replace the filter if it's necessary. And finally, if you have an auxiliary filter, check the cleanliness of the auxiliary filter bag and replace the bag if needed. Now, admittedly, that's a lot of tasks, and some of this work is more applicable to some shops than others. You know what is best for your own shop, and we encourage you to develop your own weekly maintenance checklist for your own shop. But just in case it might help, we made up a list of the tasks that I just described, and you can download it in the description below. And that's it. Remember, a small time investment now can save you expensive downtime in the future. For more service-related information, visit haascnc.com/service, and thanks for watching.